Assalamu alaikum friends, this is me Usman Chaudhary and you are watching Technology Explore. In this video, I am going to show you how you can design this type of Kaplan turbine in SolidWorks, and this is basically a final year project of engineering students and I had manufactured it on 3D printer. So if you want to buy this design for 3D printing, you can contact me. My contact details are mentioned in the description of this video. So let's start and keep watching this video till end. First of all, I will design wicket gate. So for that, click on this new button and then select part. Press OK button. From left side, click on front plane and then select sketch. Draw circles and start them from origin. Two more circles. Now define the diameter of this circle. It is 5.5 inch and the distance between both of these circles is 15 millimeter. Similarly, define this diameter. It is 15 millimeter and the distance between both of these circles is also 15 millimeter. Now go to features tab. As you can see, our sketch is now fully defined. All the arcs or lines are in black color. So now we can apply extruded boss base feature on it. Select counters and then type here the extrusion thickness, which is 30 millimeter, and then press OK button to apply this command. Now we have to create a new plane, so for that click on reference geometry here and then select plane. Drop down these options and then select top plane as first reference and type the distance from top plane to this new plane is 10 millimeter. Press OK button. Now click on this new plane one and then sketch on it. Make normal 2. You can change the shades from here. From here select line command and draw it like this. One more line. Now select both of these lines and make the relation parallel. Similarly, select center line and draw it from this midpoint up to this midpoint. Now select the center line and then this line, make the relation perpendicular. Similarly, for both of these lines, the relation is perpendicular. Now define the length. This length is 2 millimeter and this length is 8 millimeter. Again select line and close this sketch. One more line. Click and drag this sketch to your part. Press and hold control key from your keyboard and then select this point and then this line. Make the relation coincident. Similarly, select this point and this line, make the relation coincident. Now click on this arrow in front of line command and then select center line. Start the center line from the origin up to this midpoint. Click on this center line and make its relation vertical. Now define the length.
It is 30 millimeter. Select fillet command from here and fillet radius is 3 millimeter. Select this corner and then this corner. Press OK button. Again select fillet command and at this time fillet radius is 1 millimeter. Select this corner and this corner. Now press OK button. Again press OK button. Now click on this button to save and exit from sketch. So we need one more sketch somewhere here. So for that click on reference geometry and then select plane. Select top plane as first reference and type here the distance 75 millimeter. Press OK button. Now click on this plane 2 and then select sketch. Similarly click here on plane 2 and then hide it. Make normal 2 by pressing Ctrl plus 8 key from your keyboard. Now draw the same sketch by using line command. Select both of these lines and make the relation parallel. Now draw center line from this midpoint up to this midpoint. Select both of these lines and make their relation perpendicular. Similarly for both of these lines the relation is perpendicular. Select line and close the sketch. Now define the length 5 mm and this length is 15 mm. Press escape button. Now select this point and then this line, make their relation coincident. Similarly, select this line and then this point, make their relation coincident. Click and drag your sketch. Select this midpoint and then this line, make the relation coincident. Type here the length of the center line and it is 50 millimeter. Now select sketch fillet command from here and the fillet radius is 6 millimeter. Select this corner and then this corner. Again press OK button. Now select the fillet radius 2 millimeter and then select this corner and this corner. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now go to Features tab and select Lofted Pose Space command. Select two profiles. So click on this corner or this point and then select this point. Press OK button to apply this command. Now click on this arrow below the linear pattern button and then select circular pattern. Click on this box bodies and then select this loft. Now click on this box pattern axis and then select this circular edge. Type here the quantity which is 12. So press OK button. So our wicket gates are now completed. These wicket gates are fixed. So save this part. So now it's time to design propeller hub. So for that click or press Ctrl plus N key from your keyboard and then select part. From left side select front plane and then select sketch. Now click on this arrow in front of line command and select center line. Draw it from origin. Now select line and draw it like this. Now define the diameter. This is the radius. If you drag your mouse below this center line, it will become diameter. So the diameter is 1 millimeter. Width of this line is 10 millimeter. The overall diameter of the hub is 4-5 millimeter, and the width of this line is 20 millimeter. This diameter or this width is 5 millimeter, or it should be 10 millimeter. So our sketch is now fully defined. Go to Pictures tab and apply Revolve Pose Base command. It has automatically detected this center line. So press OK button to apply this command. Now click on this face and then select Sketch. Make normal 2 and then draw a rectangle. Select this midpoint and then the origin. Make the relation vertical. Now drag the rectangle something like this. Now define the width of this rectangle, that is 10 millimeter. So go to Features tab and then select Extruded Cut command. Cut it up to 14 millimeter. Press OK button. Now select Fillet command and fillet radius is 4 millimeter. Select this corner and then this corner. Press OK button. Now click on this arrow below the linear pattern and then select circular pattern. Drop down these options. Select Extrude Cut 1 and then the fillet. Now select this pattern axis box and then select this circular edge. Type here the quantity, which is 4. We are going to install 4 propeller blades on the hub. So we need 4 cuts. That is why I had typed here 4 quantity. Press OK button. So this is our hub and it is ready. Now we have to design the propeller blades. Now press Ctrl plus N key and then start from a new part. From left side again select front plane and then select sketch. Now select line and draw a sketch. Select both of these lines and make their relation parallel. Click on this arrow and then select center line. Start it from this midpoint up to this midpoint. Select both of these lines, make their relation perpendicular. Similarly, for these lines, the relation is perpendicular. Now select line and close the sketch. Define the width of this line and it is 3 millimeter. This width is 5 millimeter. Chord length is 15 millimeter. Press OK button. Press and hold Ctrl key and then select this midpoint and then origin. Make the relation coincident. From here select sketch fillet and the fillet radius is 1 millimeter. Select this corner and then this corner. Press OK button. At this time the sketch fillet radius is 2 millimeter. select this corner and then this corner. Press OK button. Now press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now we have to create a new plane, so for that click on reference geometry and then select plane. Drop down these options and then select front plane as first reference. The total distance between both of these planes is 65 mm. Press OK button. Click on this new plane 1 and then sketch on it. And from here, click on this plane 1 and hide it. Press Ctrl plus 8 key for normal 2. And then draw one more sketch like this. Select both of these lines, make their relation parallel. Then draw a center line from this midpoint up to this midpoint. And then select both of these lines and make their relation perpendicular. Similarly, make the relation for these lines perpendicular. Now draw a line and close the sketch. Define the dimensions. This width is 5 mm and this width is 8 mm. Chord length is 40 mm. Press and hold Ctrl key and select this midpoint and then the origin. Make their relation coincident. Now define the degree between this center line and then this center line. It is 140. Press OK button and then select sketch fillet command. Fillet radius is 2 mm. Select this corner and then this corner. Press OK button. And now at this time sketch fillet radius is 3 mm. Select this corner and then this corner. Press OK and again press OK button. Now press this button to save and exit from sketch. Go to Features tab and select Lofted Boss Base command. Select this corner and then this corner. Press OK button. Now select this face and then sketch on it. Make normal 2 and draw 2 circles from origin. Define them. The diameter of this circle is 10 mm and the distance between both of these circles is 3 mm. Press OK button and then go to Features tab, apply extruded boss base command. Press this button for reverse direction. Extrusion thickness is 5 mm. Press OK button. Now again click on this face and then sketch on it. Draw a circle, started from origin up to this arc. Go to Features tab and apply extruded cut command. Extrusion thickness is 15 mm. Press OK button. So now we have to edit this plane. So click on it and then select edit feature. Type here the distance 4.5 mm. Press OK button. So now click on right plane and then select sketch. Make normal 2 and then draw a point, drop it here. Click or select the point and then the origin. Make their relation horizontal. Now define the distance from the point up to this line and it is 2-3 mm. Now draw a circle and start it from this point. Now define the diameter of the circle. It is 1.35 mm. Now draw another circle and start it from this point. Define the distance between both of these circles, 20 mm. Go to Features tab and apply Extruded Cut command and cut it on both directions. Press OK button. Now select this fillet command, select this face and type here the fillet radius 2 mm. Press OK button. So propeller blade is now ready. Save this part. Now I am going to design the elbow, so start from new part and then sketch on front plane. Draw a circle, start it from origin. Define it diameter 5.5 inch. Press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now sketch on top plane and make normal 2. Now draw a line and start it from origin. Select both of these lines and make their relation equal. Define the length of this line and it is 5 inch. Now select sketch fillet command and then select this corner. Press OK button and the sketch fillet radius is 4 inch. Press OK button, again press OK button. Press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now go to Features tab and then apply swept bow space command. Select this circle as profile and then this sketch as our path. Then press OK button. Now click on this button shell and then select this face and then this face. Check this box show preview and then check this box shell out part. Here is the wall thickness and it is 8 mm. Press OK button to apply this command. Now click on this face and then select sketch. Make normal 2 by pressing Ctrl plus 8 key from your keyboard and then draw a circle. Start it from origin up to this circle and draw one more circle. Now define the distance from this circle to this circle is 1.5 mm. So this would be our flange. Go to Features tab and apply Extruded Bow Space command. Extrusion thickness is 10 mm in the reverse direction. So press this button. Again press OK button to apply this command. Now click on this face and then select sketch. Make normal 2 and then draw a center line. Change the shade. Start the center line from this midpoint up to this midpoint. Now draw a circle. Start it from origin up to this midpoint. Select this midpoint and then the circle. Make their relation intersection. Thank you. select this circle and make it for construction geometry. Now draw one more circle at this quadrant point. Define the diameter of this circle and it is 8 mm. Go to Features tab and apply Extruded Cut command. Press OK button. Now click on this arrow below the linear pattern button and then select circular pattern. Drop down these options and then select cut extrude 1. Select this box pattern axis and then select this circular edge. Type here the quantity 8 and press OK button. Now again click on this face and then select sketch, make normal 2 and then draw a circle. Define the diameter of the circle is 1.5 mm. Then go to Features tab and apply Extruded Cut command. Press OK button. Now we have to create a new plane, so click on reference geometry and then plane. Select this face as first reference. Check this box flip offset and type here the distance 200 mm. Press OK button and then click on this plane 1 and sketch on it. From here in the left side, click on this plane 1 and hide it. Make normal 2 and then draw a circle from origin. Define it 50 mm. Press OK button and then go to Features tab and apply Extruded Boss Base command. Double click on this face and press OK button. Now click on this face and then sketch. Make normal 2 and draw a circle from origin. Define the diameter of this circle and it is 35.2 mm. Press OK button and then go to Features tab and apply Extruded Cut command. Height of this extrusion is 20 mm. Then press OK button. Now click on this face and then sketch on it, make normal 2 and draw one more circle from origin. Define the diameter of this circle 1.5 mm, 1.7 mm. Press OK button and then apply Extruded Cut command. Drag this arrow. Press OK button. So this elbow is now ready. Save this part. Now we have to design the discharge tube. So press Ctrl plus N key from your keyboard and then start a new part. Click on front plane and then sketch on it. Draw a center line. Then draw one more simple line. Select this line and make it vertical. Now define the width of this line 10 mm, width of this line is also 10 mm, length of this line is 80 millimeter. The diameter of this line is 5.5 inch. Width of this line is 15 millimeter. Press escape button and then select this point and then the origin. Make their relation vertical. So now our sketch is fully defined. Go to Features tab and apply revolved bore space command. The system has automatically detected the center line as axis of revolution. So press OK button. Now click on this face and then sketch. Make normal 2 by pressing Ctrl plus 8 key from your keyboard. Change the shade and draw a center line. Start it from this quadrant point up to this quadrant point and then draw a circle. Start it from origin, then select the circle and then this midpoint. Make their relation coincident. Select this circle and convert it for construction geometry. Now draw one more circle on this quadrant point. Define it 8 millimeter and then go to Features tab and apply Extruded Cut command. Now again select Circular Pattern command and drop down these options. Select Cut Extrude 1 and then select this box pattern axis. Select this circular edge. Quantity is 8, so press OK button. Save it. Now we have to assemble all these parts together, so for that press Ctrl plus N key from your keyboard and then double click on the assembly button. Close this dialog, then open the folder where you had saved all these parts. Select all these parts and then drag them into SolidWorks assembly. Right click on the elbow and then select Fix. So our blade is fixed, right click on it and select Float. Now click on this cylindrical face of wicket gates and then select Mate. And then click on this cylindrical face of this flange. Lock the rotation and we have to reverse the direction. So flip Mate alignment. Press OK button. Now select this face and then this face. Press OK button. Similarly, select this cylindrical face of wicket gates and then this cylindrical face and then press OK button. Now select this face and then this face. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now we have to edit this wicket gates. So click on this part and then open it. Drop down these options for boss extrude 1 and then select sketch, edit it. Make normal 2 by pressing Ctrl plus 8 key from your keyboard. Delete this distance relation 1.5 and define the diameter of this circle 189.70. Press OK button and then press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now click on this face and then select sketch, make normal to draw a circle from origin. Define this diameter 174.70 millimeter. Select this circle and press this box or check this box for construction and press OK button. Now draw another circle on this quadrant point. Define the diameter 9 millimeter. Go to Features tab and select Extruded Cut command. Cut it from throughout. Press OK button. Then apply Circular Pattern command. Drop down these options and then select Cut Extrude 2. Select this box for pattern axis and then select this circular edge. Quantity is 8. Press OK button. Now save it and then go to assembly again. So now it is okay. Unhide the discharge tube by clicking on it and then show component. Also edit this flange, click on it and then open it. Drop down this option for boss extrude 1 and then edit the sketch. Make normal 2 and then delete this relation and define the diameter of this circle 189.70. Press this button to save and exit from sketch. Now edit this sketch for cut extrude 1. Delete this center line and then define the diameter of this circle 174.70. Press this button to save and exit from sketch. So now go to assembly. Now it is okay. Select the circular face and then select mate. Now select this circular face. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now it's time to assemble the hub. So click on this cylindrical face of hub and select mate. Now select this cylindrical face. Reverse the direction and press OK button. Now select this face and then this face. Click on this button distance and press this button for flip dimension. Type here the distance and it is 30 millimeter. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now click on this discharge tube and hide it. Then select this cylindrical face and select mate. Select this cylindrical face. Flip mate alignment and do not lock rotation. Press OK button. Select this face and then this face. Select flip mate alignment and press OK button. Again press OK button. Press space button and then select this view orientation. Adjust the degree for the blade. Right click on the hub and fix it, close. Now adjust the degree. Again right click on the hub and make it float. Now drop down these mid options and then click on this concentric mate of blade with the hub and edit it. Check this box, lock rotation. Press OK button. Again press OK button. As we need four blades, so click on this arrow below the linear component pattern and then select circular component pattern. Select the blade and then click on this box pattern axis and select this circular edge. Type here the quantity 4 press OK button. Press the space button and then select this view orientation. We have to decrease the distance from wicket gates to hub. So for that, in the mates option, here is the distance mate. So click on it and edit it. Type here the distance 2 millimeter. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now unhide the discharge tube. So click on it and then select show component. Change the colors of all parts one by one. Now we have to design the shaft. So for that, first of all, we need to know the dimensions or total length of the shaft. Click on the discharge tube and then hide it. Similarly, hide the wicket gates. Now simply go to sketch tab and then select smart dimensions and then press this button, reference dimension. Select this face. And this face. So total length of shaft is 241.50 millimeter from this point or this face to this face. So now we can easily design the shaft. So for that, start from a new part. From here, sketch on front plane. Now draw a sketch by using line command. Start it from origin. Define the total length from this point or this line up to this line. And it is 241.50 millimeter. Define this length it is 30 millimeter. This length is 20 millimeter. Rearrange the sketch and define this length 40 millimeter. This radius is 18 millimeter. This radius is 7.5 millimeter. This radius is 3 millimeter. And this radius is 5 millimeter. So our sketch is now fully defined. Change this radius from 18 to 9 millimeter and then go to features tab and apply a revolved boss base command. Select this line as axis of revolution, press OK button to apply this command. Now we have to make bearing. So for that, start from new part and then sketch on front plane. Draw a center line and then draw two rectangles. Select all these four lines and make them equal. Similarly, select these two lines and make them collinear and equal. Now select origin and then this point, make their relation vertical. Now define these lines. This width is 10 millimeter and this diameter is 15 millimeter. This diameter is 35 millimeter. This width is 4 millimeter. Then draw a center line, start it from this midpoint up to this midpoint, and then draw a circle from this midpoint, define it, eight millimeter is the diameter of this circle, and then select trim entities command, trim these extra lines. Press OK button and then apply revolved boss base command. Press OK button. Then select front plane and sketch on it. Make normal to change the shade and draw a circle on this point. Now draw a line from this midpoint up to this midpoint. Select trim entities and trim one side of the circle. Go to features tab and apply revolved boss base command. Select this line as axis of revolution and press OK button. Click on this revolved or this ball and then change its color revolved to now click on this button below the linear pattern button and select circular pattern. Check this box bodies and then select this revolve or this ball. Now select pattern axis box and select this circular edge. Quantity is 9. Press OK button. Select this bearing and change its color, revolve 1. Yellow and press OK button. Save it. Now we have to design this water seal. So for that, start from new part again and then sketch on front plane, draw center line, click on it and make it horizontal, draw a line like this, define it. This diameter is 15 millimeter and this diameter is 35 millimeter. This width is 9 millimeter. Select origin and then this point, make their relation vertical. Our sketch is now fully defined, so go to features tab and apply revolved both base command. Press no and then in the thin features tab select the width 2 millimeter and press OK button. Now save this part as seal. Now go to assembly again and import all these parts one by one. Open the folder, select seal, shaft and bearing, drag them into assembly. Select the cylindrical face of shaft and then select mate. Now select the cylindrical face of bearing. Do not lock rotation and press OK button. Now select this face of shaft and then this face. Press OK button. Similarly, select the cylindrical face of seal and then the shaft. Press OK button. Select this face and then this face of bearing. Press OK button. Press OK button. Now change the colors for shaft and seal. Now select the cylindrical face of shaft and then select mate. Select the cylindrical face of hub and at this time lock the rotation. Press OK button. Now select this face of hub and then this face of shaft. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Unhide the wicket gates and the discharge tube. Now we have to make its exploded view. So for that, go to configuration manager here and then right click on default and select new exploded view. Scroll down and then select the discharge tube, drag it, then select runner with the hub, drag them also. Select shaft and drag it backward. Now select wicket gates and drag them. So this is our Kaplan turbine, simply designed in SolidWorks. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any suggestions, please write them in comment section. Thanks for watching and sparing time.